Loss on drying LOD determines moisture levels in samples, crucial for stability and compliance in pharmaceuticals. This gravimetric method uses heat to measure weight loss from water and volatile substances. Instruments like hot air ovens or moisture analyzers are employed, with care needed to avoid results affected by moisture reabsorption. Ensuring accurate measurements through calibration and controlling environmental factors is vital in obtaining reliable LOD. Here are commonly asked interview questions on loss on drying, LOD, in the pharmaceutical industry, along with detailed answers. 1. What is loss on drying, LOD? Answer: LOD is a method used to determine the amount of water and volatile matter present in a sample by drying the sample under specified conditions, usually temperature and time, and measuring the weight loss. It reflects both free and bound moisture. 2. Why is LOD performed in pharmaceuticals? Answer: LOD is performed to ensure product stability, proper formulation, and compliance with pharmacopeial specifications. Excess moisture can lead to degradation, microbial growth, and reduced shelf life. 3. What is the principle of LOD? Answer: LOD works on the principle of gravimetric analysis, where the weight loss of the sample upon drying is measured and attributed to moisture and other volatile substances. 4. What instruments are used for LOD? Answer: hot air oven with desiccator and balance. Halogen moisture analyzer, moisture balance. 5. What is the standard temperature used for LOD testing? Answer: typically 105 degs is used for drying unless otherwise specified in the monograph or method. Heat sensitive substances may require lower temperatures or vacuum drying. 6. What is the difference between LOD and water content? Carl Fisher. Answer: LOD measures all volatile substances including water and solvents. Carl Fisher titration specifically measures only water content, accurate for hygroscopic and heat-sensitive materials. 7. How do you calculate LOD? Answer: text/LOD, pulse percent, evofrac pulse text, initial weight, final weight, text, initial weight, times 100, 8. What is the purpose of using a desiccator after drying? Answer: to prevent moisture absorption from the atmosphere before weighing, as the sample is usually hygroscopic after drying. 9. What are common causes of high LOD results? Answer: incomplete drying, hygroscopic sample, weighing errors, contamination with volatile solvents, use of incorrect drying temperature. 10. How do you ensure accuracy in LOD using a moisture balance? Answer: calibrate the balance regularly. Use proper sample amount, usually 1-3G, set correct drying temperature and method. Ensure stable environment, no air drafts, vibration, use repeatable sample placement. 11. What is the difference between LOD using hot air oven and moisture analyzer? Answer: hot air oven, traditional method, takes more time, gravimetric. Moisture analyzer, rapid real-time drying with halogen lamp, suitable for routine analysis. 12. What precautions should be taken during LOD analysis? Answer: use pre-dried containers. Avoid touching samples with bare hands. Weigh samples quickly to avoid moisture pickup. Maintain consistent drying conditions. Use a calibrated balance and oven. 13. What is the significance of constant weight? Answer: constant weight ensures that all volatile matter is removed. It is confirmed when two successive weights do not differ by more than 0.5 milligillies after repeated dry. 14. How do you handle hygroscopic substances in LOD? Answer: use sealed containers, minimize exposure time during weighing, weigh quickly, and place immediately in the oven. Cool in a desiccator. 15. What would you do if LOD fails out of specification? Answer: recheck sample preparation and balance calibration. Repeat the test. Conduct investigation. OS. Review environmental and instrument conditions. Report to QA for further action. Thank you so much for your attention. If like this video, please subscribe my channel, Tomar Pharma Classes.